Hello, friends. Happy Tuesday. While we were apart, I went back to Splinter Town to get Puggsy re-equipped, and I also worked my way back around to the other side of Fireheart. I figure I'll come through the volcano on this side and work my way back to the castle. Let's go. Ready. Oh, well, I didn't have to go back for speed shoes. Oh, it's slippery. That snowman tried to kill me. So did that one. Ah! Oh no. Okay. Well, I'm glad it gave me an extra pair of shoes then. I don't like this one bit. The ultimate defense against snowmen. A gun. Snow notoriously vulnerable to bullets. Is this an Arctic raccoon? That's not a thing. I mean, I guess they would evolve into a thing if there was some sort of massive climate catastrophe. But, that's not going to happen. So this gun is kaput when it runs out of, what's the kind of bullets that go in, like, a flintlock pistol? I guess it's just called a ball. Anyway, when it runs out of that, it breaks in half to demonstrate. Alright, so the intended exit is that way. So that makes me think that this is just a decoy exit that won't go anywhere. But I have to test the theory. I bounced off the wall. So, yeah, the level was marked as complete, but that exit did not actually go anywhere. Oh, if only the speed shoes were also snowshoes. Ah! Ah! I have a frighten. Ah! Also, the snowmen were wearing scarves, which I guess that makes sense. You know, a scarf is just an insulator. So, for humans and raccoons, it would keep in the warmth. But with a snowman, it would keep in the cold, which is what they want. I'm scared. I have great trepidation. Okay, I think I'm safe. Whee! Oh, if you weren't paying attention, you could totally just slide right into the fake door. I see why that's a thing now. Alright, let's try to triangulate here and figure out exactly where the best place to use this balloon is. I'm guessing here because it gives me a flat surface. Hopefully this doesn't trap me somehow. Yeah, I think eventually I'll have to play the Mega Drive version just to see what the music sounds like, see what other differences there are. The Mega Drive version of Puggsy back in the day, this probably is no longer a concern, but that game was notoriously one of the examples of copy protection on a console game. It let you play a few levels, and then It does some sort of check related to the SRAM. I'm not sure exactly how it works, but it gives you like a little demo, and then it gives you a message saying, thank you for trying Puggsy, now go play a real game instead of the silly copy. Which I think it's pretty, like, as far as anti-piracy stuff goes, that's kind of the kindest way to do it. But I imagine that that wouldn't be a wouldn't be a problem with modern emulators. So I should probably check that out at some point. But first, I'll check out Badger Mill. So when the flour goes through the fire, it turns into bread, which is exactly how baking works in a bakery. Alright, so our hints are a torch, a gun. Okay, a torch and a gun. I wonder if this is CD audio. This sounds almost like music that would come out of a Mega Drive. But this might just be a normal, like, FM synth track. Okay, so that torch fell. Ah! Sentient monster bread. Sentient monster wheat. I mean, the wheat's... I mean, it's kind of creepy looking, but it's not attacking me like the bread was. Ugh. Gives me the jibblies. Okay, so I cannot... This wooden beam is in the foreground, not the background, so it's preventing me from getting that key. Okay, so I'm guessing take the torch up to the fires, light it, and then use it to burn that rope and drop the weight. You have to burn the rope. Oh, well, it just looped, so I guess this is an actual CD audio track. There are Sega CD games that use both CD audio and FM synth audio. Sonic CD is my favorite example. It uses like actual instrumentation for... Well, in the US version, at least. I'm not sure about the Japanese version. And I know the music is different, but I'm not sure to what extent. But in the US version, it uses like modern instrumental... Well, it's electronic music, but I think there are some actual instruments as well. But when you go into the past, that's all video game music, which I think is a nice touch. Excellent. I shall bring with me a loaf of bread. Yeah, Sonic CD is a good game. One of the other handful of good games on the Sega CD. Weren't a lot of bangers on that platform. Sonic CD, Puggsy. Like, there was a version of Echo the Dolphin, which I haven't played, but that's just a version of a Mega Drive game with different music. Which I guess you could say that about Puggsy too, although this game is expanded from the Mega Drive version. There are extra bosses to fight. And I don't know what the other differences are. Maybe I should have done this LP of that version instead of just replaying the Sega CD version. So I could at least see what the differences are. But I wanted to first sort of remind myself of this game since it's been so long. So I'm better equipped to play the Mega Drive version now. I don't think I'll do that immediately after this LP, but I may go back and check that out at some point. And then there's also the Amiga version, which for a while I wasn't sure if there was actually a version of this game on the Amiga. Like, I know Puggsy started as an Amiga demo called Pugs in Space, but I think for a while there wasn't really footage of the Amiga version of Puggsy on YouTube, so I wasn't sure if this game actually came out on the Amiga. But it did. You can go look at footage of the Amiga version on YouTube. And from what I could tell from like the tiny little bit I watched, it seemed, you know, pretty similar. Nice shot. So we have to pay the basketball toll to get through this door. Ah! We must become a master of the Puggsy physics. I do wonder why they used coins here. And not like... Well, you wouldn't want to use beach balls here because the physics wouldn't be... The physics of beach balls would make this much harder. But you could make like a different kind of ball with the same physics as the coins. I think that was enough, no? I do remember it doesn't require all the coins. Or I may be misremembering that. Oh no! Okay. Like, I think it gives you an extra. Or I thought it gave you two extras, but maybe it's just one. But yeah, good Sega CD games. There's a version of Final Fight that people enjoy. It has a soundtrack that I personally don't find the soundtrack to that game. I don't find that soundtrack that compelling. It's sort of like butt rock. And there's a Spider-Man game for the Sega CD that also has a butt rock soundtrack. A lot of butt rock. I mean, there were a ton of Sega CD games I played that were not actually good. A lot of FMV games. Sewer Shark. There's a version of Dragon Slayer. Those aren't good games. Nice. So... It just gives us a remote so we can check on the progress of that Switch. That's nice of them. Rise of the Dragon was a Sega CD adventure game, which may... Parts of that might hold up. It's been a long time. Of course, Snatcher, which is... There are good and bad qualities to Snatcher. I mean, it's worth playing, for sure. Alright, Badger Mill. Do I have a level or just a boss? Okay, I guess the bosses always come after you complete a level. Ah. So, there are 4 switches, and... I have to make sure that a sack of flour falls on each of the switches. The way I do that is by changing the direction of these conveyor belts by standing in front of the right switch. Alright, so for this one, I'm going to wait for it to fall, and then I'm going to figure out which switch will send it over to the right. Is it this one? No. Is it this one? Ah, I messed that up. Oh well. Yeah, it gives you exactly the number of sacks of flour you need. So if you miss one, it's game over. And you would be, like, permanently stuck if it didn't give you the pause and press all 3 buttons at the same time. So, like, I wonder how many kids just didn't know about that. And just had to reset the console every time they got stuck like that. I figure the number was greater than 0. Alright. Alright, so that one is flipped. So now I need to do the second one from the left. Which means I need to let it fall. And then... probably that first one. Yes, or no, the middle one. Okay, that should be it. Yay! And here's a sack of flour. You can spray flour everywhere in celebration. Alright, guardian time. Let's go. I am ready to defeat guardian. Alright, so here is the eponymous badger. We have these levers here that we flip to move this thing. Like a crane game, only extremely complicated. I think I'm safe whenever as long as I stand at the leftmost edge of the screen. Alright, so I need to let go of the flower somehow. Okay. Mercifully, the badger only has 3 hit points. So this won't take forever. I just have to, have to figure out an efficient way of doing this. Okay, I think there we go. So I just have to get this claw in the right position. One more time. A little further down, I think. There we go. I have defeated Guardian. Let's see what's going on with Puggsy's ship. So, last time we saw it, a whale was pushing it somewhere. Looks like the whale has pushed Puggsy's ship to some sort of dam. And its job complete. The whale sinks below the waves. Alright, that's Badger Mill out of the way. Could have done that earlier, but I'm being thorough. Alright, so is there an exit from this level leading to the next part of Fireheart? No, this level only has the one exit. Okay, that's okay. I'll wrap back around this way. Yeah, I was sort of on the outside of the volcano on that level. Oh no. Oh no. I didn't get moving fast enough. This is the speedrun level. And I lost my speed shoes. Alright, let's wait for those snowballs to bounce away and see what's over to the left. Or I could die. I could be killed. That's an option too. Run, Puggsy! Oh, jeez. And that leads nowhere. Awesome. Okay, well... I'll grab some more speed shoes. And I might as well go grab some sunglasses too. It's not too far of a trek. It's much nicer than Super Mario World, because in that game you have to backtrack all the way to the top secret area every time you want to load up on power-ups. And you move around the map much more slowly in that game. Puggsy's pretty nice about it. Alright, Fireheart. Round 2. Yeah, I kind of thought those snowballs would stop bouncing once they hit the bottom of the mountain. Oh god, I shouldn't have jumped. Why did I jump? I panicked. Don't panic, Puggsy. Don't panic. Just run. Just run for your life, but don't panic. Alright. Alright, snowballs. Grab some more speed shoes. Like, they do sort of give you an equivalent to the top secret area down at the secret cove. If you do those chests in the right order, you can get a pair of sunglasses and speed shoes. But it's not necessary. You can just go back to any level and exit. Oh, there's sunglasses right here. That's nice. See, there are a couple levels in a row where it gives you the, you know, one power up in each level. So clearly they intend for you to do that. Oh boy. Those raccoons were fast. Alright, let's blow up the top of a volcano with dynamite. What could possibly go wrong? Ow. Alright, we got some orbs. We got like a raccoon prospector. I probably shouldn't have thrown that orb into the volcano. Mea culpa. So that is the correct exit. I probably need that fourth orb. And shoes would also probably help. Like, I don't think there's a way for me to go down there and survive. But I don't actually know. Okay. That is nothing. Good to know. Alright, let's grab my power-ups. Nope. No, that's not power-ups. This is power-ups. This is pod racing. Alright. Puggsy is as cool as possible again. With his sunglasses and his several $100 sneakers that he had to download a bot to make sure he could buy them from the website before they sold out. Like that's an actual thing. There are bots that you can buy that will watch a website for you when sneakers go on sale and make sure that that you get them before stock runs out. The internet is weird. People are weird. Shoes aren't that important. Alright, I have all four orbs. Oh. Okay. Well, that's a relief. I was really worried I was going to have to, like, stack them and climb my way up there. But there appears to be hidden levitation points. That's a lot easier than how I was going to try to do it. You knocked them out of place. Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah, Puggsy almost immediately falls through, so you have to kind of bounce off of him. If you hold down the button, Puggsy, you'll just keep jumping like that. There's almost never a reason to do that, but I'm glad that's a thing here. Alright, get ready to defeat Guardian. A dragon! Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Puggsy got hurt. So this dragon's name, as given in the manual, is Halitosis. Which, when I was a kid, I thought that was just a cool-sounding dragon name. I didn't realize that that was a word that, mouthwash marketing people made up that means bad breath. So do I just... Oh. I just headbutt it. Headbutt him. Okay. I mean, that's kind of a good joke, but, when I was a kid, I mean, it is a cool, like, out of context, Halitosis would be a cool dragon name. Like, it has sort of a, sort of a faux ancient Greek kind of sound to it. I love his dainty little walk. It's nice that taking damage from a boss doesn't make you lose your power-ups. I need to stand here. Alright, well, there goes my no damage streak. Only two bosses left. So, someone commented, I forget their name, I apologize, but they said that the Mega Drive version and the Amiga version has three fewer bosses. So, it must be a significantly shorter game on those platforms. Alright, Puggsy's ship is being lifted up the dam. Alright, well, that seems like a pretty decent stopping point. So, tune in tomorrow for the continuing adventures of Puggsy the Alien. Goodbye.